Salutations. My name is David, and I'm an engineer on the SwiftData team. SwiftData history is a new technology that lets your app track modifications to its data. You can use history to build features that need to process these changes, like syncing with your server or responding to changes from an app extension. In this video, I'll cover the fundamentals of SwiftData history and build a new feature in my sample app using history, transactions, and changes. Finally, I'll cover some considerations for supporting history with a custom data store. Let's talk about what SwiftData history is and why you might want to use it. As people use an app, the content stored by SwiftData changes over time. For example, when the app launches, it may create some models or insert models fetched from a remote server. When the model context is saved, all pending changes are saved into the data store. Over time, some of these models may change or be deleted as someone uses and interacts with your app and its different functions. At any time, your app can query the data in the store. However, a query's results represent what's currently in the data store. Without history or manual diffing, there's no way to know from a query which models may have been added, deleted, or updated since a previous one. SwiftData history provides an easy and efficient way to track the changes in your data store over time. You can use this to build a number of different features. For example, you may want to have a time-ordered log of changes that occur when the app is offline. Later, these changes can be efficiently synced with a remote server. You may want to discover changes in the data that occurred in a different process, like a widget extension, so that you can reflect those changes properly in your app. Or you may simply want an efficient way to know which models were inserted or deleted since a previous query in order to update some state at runtime. Let's explore how this works. SwiftData history lets your app query and process changes in the order that they occurred. Each time your model is saved, it records a transaction, which contains metadata about all of the changes. SwiftData history is composed of transactions and changes. Transactions group together all of the changes that occurred in the data store on a boundary, such as a model context save. Transactions are ordered by when they occurred. Within a transaction, the set of changes it contains also preserve the order in which each change occurred. Each change represents a model that has been inserted, updated, or deleted, and are parameterized by a persistent model. This allows references to the properties of the persistent model using key paths. SwiftData history uses the concept of a token, which acts as a bookmark for transactions in history. A token can help your app keep track of the last transaction it processed in the stream of history. Tokens are only valid for the data stores they're associated with. In SwiftData, history information can be deleted through the model context. When that happens, tokens from deleted parts of history become expired and cannot be used for fetches. SwiftData history operations involving an expired token will throw a history token expired error. If this happens, discard the token as it is no longer valid and fetch a new one. When models are deleted, the data in the model is discarded. This means that essential data like identifiers might be lost and don't provide enough information to your app when processing history information. To address this, SwiftData history lets you preserve specific attributes on a model. When the model is deleted, these attributes are preserved as tombstone values and let you process the history information for the deleted models. Attributes in a persistent model that have been marked with the modifier .preserve value on deletion are preserved in the tombstone. Tombstones are also parameterized by a persistent model so that their key paths can be used to retrieve the tombstone values or iterated as desired. History in SwiftData is easy to consume and built on the rich type system of Swift. Let's explore how to use it in an app. To see it in action, I'm going to work on a new feature for the Sample Trips app. This app lets me record all of my favorite trips to help me plan my next vacation. I want to add a new feature where trips that have unread changes are badged for my review. This can happen outside of the app in the context of a sync from a remote server or in the app's widget. In the widget, I'm going to add the capability to confirm a given living accommodation right from my home screen. Using SwiftData history, I can build this feature by finding out when this data changed, who changed it, and update the UI. To do this, I'm going to break the task into three steps. Fetch SwiftData history, process the changes by inspecting the properties on the change, and finally, update my user interface. To start, I'll build a function that fetches transactions in the data store based on a token parameter and author. In this case, the token is of type default history token because the app uses the default store in SwiftData. Next, I'll create a history descriptor, which lets me configure constraints for my request. I'll build a predicate that constrains the transaction to have occurred after the provided token. Since I want this function to only surface changes from my widget, I'll also add a constraint to fetch changes authored by a specified author. If I'm calling this function without a token, I'll just fetch all of the available history. Next, I'll create an array that will contain all of the transactions that need to be processed. And I'll call fetchHistory on the model context using the descriptor. This will provide a set of default history transactions that I can then iterate through. Now that I'm able to retrieve the transactions I care about, I'm going to define another function for processing them. This function will accept an array of transactions and return a set of trips that need to be badged having unread changes and a token. Each time the function runs, it will return a new token that I can use the next time I want to find changes. I'll begin by defining a model context and a set that will store my trips with unread changes. For each transaction and change in a transaction, the History API provides the persistent model ID. To get the model instance for the trip, I'll build a fetch descriptor for living accommodation using that persistent model ID. Then, I'll fetch that model from the model context and store the trip associated with the living accommodation. To determine if a change in a transaction represents an insert, update, or deletion, I'll use a switch statement to check its type. In the app, I want to apply a badge in the UI if my widget inserts, changes, or deletes a living accommodation model. To do that, I'll start by checking for changes of type default history insert for living accommodation. If this case matches, it represents an insert of a living accommodation, so I'll add this trip to the set. Again, notice that the type is called default history insert because in this case, I'm using the default store for this model. I'll also check for updates by adding a case for the type default history update of a living accommodation. If this change is an update, I'll update the trip in the set. If the trip is deleted, there's nothing I need to do in the app's interface. To handle this, I'll add a case for the type default history delete of a living accommodation and remove it from my set. Finally, I'll return the last token along with my set of trips so that future calls to this function return only the changes that have occurred after that transaction. Using SwiftData history, The app can now discover which trips were changed from the widget since the last time the app checked for changes. Now, I need to store this token so that it only considers changes since the last time changes were discovered. To do this, I'll define a third function and use user defaults to store the most recent token. In my function findUnreadTrips, I'll fetch the token if there's one available and decode it from JSON before calling my findTransactions function with that token. The author I want to specify is the widget, so in the widget, I've set the .author property on a model context equal to transactionAuthor.widget. After calling findTrips, I'll store the return token back into user defaults. Now, each time I call findUnreadTrips, it will only return trips which need to be badged since the last time it was called. My feature is almost ready. There's just two more pieces I need to add. One, when the app is opened, I'll check for unread trips. And two, when a trip is tapped on, I'll remove it from the set of unread trips so that the badge disappears. On my Swift UI view, I'll call findUnreadTripIdentifiers anytime the scene phase becomes active. This will update the interface with the new trips that need to be badged. Then, when a trip is selected, I'll remove its identifier from the unReadTripIdentifier set so that the badge disappears. Finally, I'll add the badge to any trip that is contained within the unReadTripIdentifier set. Now that all the required code is implemented, I'll build and run the app. There's already a trip entered in the app, and I want to confirm the living accommodations in my widget right on the home screen. I'll tap Accommodation, and the UI will change to indicate it is confirmed. The next time I launch the Trips app, the trip to the Formation flyover will have a blue unread badge indicating there's been changes to that trip. After reviewing the trip, the badge is removed. For those of you building custom data stores with SwiftData, your custom store can also support history. If your underlying model supports it, you can support these same workflows with your store implementation as well. To add history to your custom data store, you'll need to implement your own types to represent the fundamental elements of the SwiftData History API for your data store. This includes transactions, each type of change, and a token to act as a bookmark between transactions. In addition, your custom data store will need to conform to history providing. The boundaries of a transaction will need to be well-defined because write operations in your data store need to be coalesced and ordered. In the default store, all of the changes to model instances on the model context at save time are grouped as a single transaction. When you create your transaction type, you'll need to define a way to uniquely identify a transaction within your persistence backend. Similarly to transactions, what defines the boundaries of a change must be well defined. In the default store, the boundaries of a change are scoped to an individual model instance. Pick an identifier that can track the granular nature of these changes. It's possible that your app may not need all of the existing change types, or it may need different change types. For example, if your app only ever inserts models as a time series log, you may not need update and delete change types. An additional consideration is if your app will need to support preserving values on deletion, and how the deleted values will be stored. The custom store will need to implement the history providing protocol to vend history. This will require being able to pull together rows from the store that define the transaction and changes. After identifying which rows are part of a transaction, you'll need to build the specific sets of models. The default data store manages the time to live of history records. As a custom provider, you'll need to decide when to delete history. While SwiftData history is robust and can handle a large amount of history data, in some specific cases, you may want to delete history. For example, if you remove models from your app, there may be history data about those models that you would never use going forward. In that case, you might like to delete this history from the data store. Finally, when adding history support to your custom store, you'll need to create a custom type of token. History token is the base protocol for a token. The state is needed to uniquely identify your position in the stream of transactions. Consider if your app uses multiple related stores. Your custom token should include the state of all the stores used in the transaction. History is a powerful feature that lets you query for changes, like discovering the update from the widget in Trips. SwiftData uses Swift's expressive type system to make it easy to understand how each model change gets used in your app. You can build delightful experiences in your app with SwiftData history. For those of you using coexistence with core data to benefit from persistent history, you can now migrate to SwiftData history instead. And if you're building a custom store, you can support all of the features of history tracking by creating your own history types. Thanks for watching.